And from testing for the virus to testing for antibodies, more strides are being made to make plasma transfusion a widespread treatment for COVID-19.
As Devin Clark explains, local doctors say antibodies that help fight the disease peak 28 days after infection. And within that frame, not all plasma is able to be used.
Doctors Hyrule Mello and Bravina Malakuan are COVID-19 experts at Texas Intensivist Pulmonary and Sleep Medicine, the critical care group leading experimental plasma transfusion treatments in San Antonio. They're calling on former patients to be donors, but there are factors that would make some ineligible.
Specifically is if you have a prior diagnosis of HIV, prior diagnosis of a viral hepatitis, you wouldn't be an eligible candidate to donate your blood.
There are also weight and heart rate requirements.
If you have a high heart rate or a very low heart rate, it would be a case-by-case basis.
And blood pressure must read normal in order to donate. Recipients don't have as many requirements.
The inclusion criteria is simply you need to be admitted to a hospital, quote-unquote you're sick, and you need to be in respiratory failure.
Whether you receive a plasma transfusion, doctors here at Texas IPS say it's very important for all former COVID-19 patients to follow up with their doctors for routine checkups.
We want to know what your lung function is, what your heart is doing, what your blood tests are doing.
In some cases, physicians say follow-up treatment may be necessary long after the disease clears from one system. Texas IPS doctors want to hear any questions that the public may have regarding COVID-19 and treatment during and after infection. We have details on how to reach them on KSAT.com. In the Medical Center, Devin Clark, KSAT 12 News.